إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله، وأصلي وأسلم عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وعلى تابعيهم ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. Praise be to Allah. We praise Him, we seek His guidance and forgiveness. Whomever Allah guide, none can misguide. And whomever Allah leads astray, none can guide besides Allah. We bear witness that there is no one worth worshipping but Allah. And we bear witness that Muhammad is His last prophet and messenger. Prayers and peace of Allah be upon him, upon his companions, upon his family, upon his followers and their followers till the day of judgment. Ameen. Servants of Allah, have the taqwa of Allah. That is, have the balance between the love of Allah and the fear of His punishment. Have the taqwa of Allah, that is, be aware that Allah is watching you all the time. So do not do and do not say except what makes Allah happy. Have the taqwa of Allah and do not die except on the state of Islam, the state of submission to the will and the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Amma ba'd. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ لِرَبِّكُمْ فِي دَهْرِكُمْ لَنَفَحَاتٍ أَلَا فَتَعَرَّضُوا لَهَا. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send to you throughout the year waves of blessings, breezes of mercy. So expose yourself to these waves as much as you can. You know, when you're in a hot day and you've been working outside, and then suddenly you go into in front of the AC or in front of an open window that brings you some cold air, how do you expose yourself to that air? You try to make the best out of that moment. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us, when you see some of the breezes of mercy that Allah sent to you throughout the year, try to expose yourself from it for it as much as you can. Ramadan, brothers and sisters, is pretty much the most significant one of these blessings and breezes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to us throughout the year. How are we going to expose ourselves to it? Are we just going to let it go? Are we just going to let it go just like every year? A hectic schedule, coming back from work, having iftar, running to the masjid to pray tarawih, go sleep for a couple of hours, wake up for suhoor, wake up in the morning in a cycle that you cannot wait until it ends? No. That's not what meant to have in Ramadan. This is a month that we should look for. This is a month that we should charge ourselves with. I give this example wherever I go. I say, try to imagine yourself been walking in the desert for the last 11 months without a single sip of water. You don't have any water for 11 months. Suddenly, you go through an oasis full of water, abundance of water. How are you going to drink from it? Knowing that you're going to have to go another 11 months without water. How are you going to, are you just going to take a sip? Are you just going to wash your face? Or are you going to jump into the water? We need to jump into Ramadan. We need to jump into Taraweeh. We need to jump into Quran. We need to jump into understanding what it means to fast. And we need to ask ourselves, are we happy? How did we perform last Ramadan? How was your last Ramadan? Do you think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was pleased with your last Ramadan? Do you think you achieved the purpose of fasting? Someone might not know what's the purpose of fasting. A question that people ask, why do we fast? Especially your children, when you start teaching them to fast, they will ask you, Daddy, why are you teaching me to not to eat? Why am I, something they've been doing regularly, and suddenly you're asking them not to do. So why are we fasting? And most of the parents answer their kids by saying, so we can feel with the poor and the needy. Now, if your kids are a little bit smart and they ask a lot of questions, they will tell you, why do poor people fast then? If they already know how it feels, so why do they have to fast? Yes, feeling with the poor and the hungry and the needy is one of the benefits of fasting. Getting healthier and feeling some spirituality is some of the benefits of fasting. Appreciating the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one of the secondary benefits of fasting. But the main goal of fasting is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. You are asked to fast so you can acquire this feeling, this understanding, this mental status called taqwa. A lot of people don't know what is that. And it might be a hard word, and it might need a special khutbah just to talk about taqwa. I promise inshallah sometime in the future I'll come and talk just about taqwa. But today I'm going to give you a prescription so you can acquire this taqwa during this month of Ramadan. This is the first khutbah of Ramadan, and there is nothing else we can talk about except about Ramadan and how to get the best out of it. Just like the prescription you get from the doctor. You don't ask how does it work. You just take it. I'm giving you a prescription. Just take it, and inshallah, you will benefit and you'll understand and you'll reach the feeling of taqwa from this Ramadan. Number one, mental status. Ramadan just entered and Ramadan just started. We need to prepare ourselves mentally for the month of Ramadan. What does that mean? We need, first of all, to be thankful and grateful that we lived to live through this blessed time. Are we thankful for that? Are we grateful that we had another chance to go through another Ramadan? We need to have determination that this Ramadan, I'm not going to leave it without being forgiven and without being freed from hellfire, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that at the end of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will free so many people from hellfire. We need to have the mental status of happiness that we are in Ramadan. You know, amazingly, some people are bothered by the Ramadan. They might not say it. They might just have it in their mind. They are bothered because they're not smoking. They are bothered because they're not drinking their cup of coffee in the morning. No! We need to be happy that Ramadan is here. You know, if you ask any of the children in the area, what is your favorite day of the year? They're going to tell you my birthday, or Christmas if they're not Muslims, or their Eid if they're Muslims. Why? Why do they like that time? Because they get a lot of gifts. Guess what? We're getting a lot of gifts in these 30 days. And we should be happy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just pouring His gifts on us. Let us think about some of the gifts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us during the month of Ramadan. For example, and all of you know these gifts, just a reminder. Laylatul Qadr, the night of Al-Qadr. Better than 1,000 nights. Imagine that anything you do on that night equals 1,000 times. If you pray 2 rak'ahs on Laylatul Qadr, as if you prayed 2,000 rak'ahs, khayrun min alfi shahr, 30,000, I'm sorry. If you donated $1 on Laylatul Qadr, as if you donated $30,000. When you say Subhanallah on Laylatul Qadr, as if you've been saying it 30,000 times. Isn't that a gift that I should be happy with? More than the whole year. Look at this gift. What Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you feed someone who's fasting, if you break his fast, you give him some food to break his fast on, you will get the reward of that person without him losing anything. So imagine yourself having this dinner at your house. Yeah, we're happy, it's hectic, we have to prepare for the food. But be happy that you're inviting all these people. If you're sponsoring an iftar in the masjid, you don't really care if they put your name on the board out there. All what you care about to get the reward of the 1,000 people that they're going to break the fast on. And imagine one of these people been reading the Quran the whole day. You're getting that reward as well. Sisters, when you are preparing iftar at home, don't complain. Don't say, I'm so tired, I'm fasting, I cannot. Don't have a smile on your face. Because if you have 5 members in your family, your reward is multiplied by 5. Because you are the one who's preparing the food. And don't go crazy if your husband decides after Maghrib to bring 2 more people. Say, Alhamdulillah, more reward. Isn't that a beautiful gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us? The forgiveness and the freedom from hellfire, among the many gifts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us. The angels now are asking for your forgiveness. You know, when we shake someone's hand and say, make dua for me. We think he's a righteous person. Please ask Allah to forgive me. Make dua for me. Imagine the angels are making dua and then asking Allah, oh, forgive him. Oh, forgive her. Until you break your fast. Another gift. The moment that the adhan of the Maghrib comes, before you put the first bite in your mouth, you have an answered dua. A wish. Better than the 3 wishes of the genie. 30 wishes. You can spend hours and days prepare for them. The minute you hear the adhan, make those wishes. Make dua for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then grab the first bite of date and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer it for you. These are some of the gifts that a lot of us know. The next thing, we need to plan. That's the next part of the prescription. We need to plan for Ramadan. We plan for our vacations. We plan for our business. We plan for our studying of the finals. Why don't we plan for Ramadan? Have a piece of paper and write on it. How many tarawih rak'ahs are you going to pray every night? How many times are you going to go to the masjid throughout the week? Because now you are free at lunchtime. You don't have to spend an hour eating. You can come to the masjid. How many juz'ah of the Quran are you going to read this month of Ramadan? Are you planning to read the whole Quran? By the way, it's so funny that a lot of Muslims, they've been living for 40, 50 years, and they never read the Quran from cover to cover. I have non-Muslim friends, they ask for a copy of the Quran, I give it to them, after 1 month they come to me and said, I read it all. Do you have anything else to read? Read it. Someone might say, but I don't read Arabic. You don't have to read Arabic. Listen to it. Read it in English. Spend 1 hour a day reading one juz'ah or listening to one juz'ah of the Quran. 30 days, you'll finish it. Plan for how many surahs you're going to memorize. When was the last time you memorized a new surah in the Quran? When was the last time you sat down and memorized this page of the Quran? So instead of reading قُلْ وَاللَّهُ أَحَدْ every day in your salah, why don't you change? Read something else. Memorize and add to your memorization. Write on that piece of paper how much you're going to donate. Don't laugh at this plan, by the way. Don't say that's a childish idea. No, no, no. Each one of us going to have in the Day of Judgment a record, just like that one. وَكُلَّ إِنسَانٍ أَلْزَلْنَاهُ طَائِرَهُ فِي عُنُقِي وَنُخْرِجُ لَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ كِتَابًا يَلْقَاهُ مَسْتُورًا اِقْرَأْ كِتَابَكَ كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ حَسِيبًا. The only difference between this record and the record in the Day of Judgment, that this one you can cheat in it. You can add on it stuff that you did not do. You can change it. You can improve it. But the one in the Day of Judgment is sealed. You cannot touch it. And don't forget to add something for your heart during the month of Ramadan. Most of us pay attention to the outside ibadah, to the salah, to the taraweeh, to reading the Quran, but very few of us actually care about the heart. Write down on that piece of paper, how many people are you planning to forgive this Ramadan? Every day, forgive one person. Have in your heart that instead of you're going to pray 8 or 20 rak'ahs every day without knowing how many rak'ahs and what is reciting, have khushu'. You know, what is the most common question asked in Ramadan? In my opinion, the most common asked question, even though it's not said loudly, is what people say at the first rak'ah of Taraweeh, when is he going to finish? Why is that? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ. Salah is a burden. Salah is hard. Salah might be boring on those who do not have khushu'. If you do not have khushu', you're going to feel that it's a long rak'ah. It's a long salah. When it's going to finish? And khushu' means that you are focusing and concentrating in your salah. I'll tell you a funny story that I maybe said it here once before. A man used to go pray in a masjid next to his business every night for Isha. On one of the nights, after the salah, the imam only prayed 3 rak'ahs by mistake. But no one paid attention because they trust the imam. He raised up his hand from the back and he said, Ya Sheikh, you only prayed 3 rak'ahs today. Everyone's like, what are you talking about? You're doubting our imam? How can you say he prayed only 3 rak'ah? Can you prove it? He said, every night I come and pray Isha with you. And I have 4 grocery stores. In every rak'ah of these 4 rak'ahs, I do my calculation and accounting to one of my grocery stores. Today, I did not get the chance to get to my 4th store. That means he only prayed 3 rak'ahs. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. That means he's not paying attention to that. Some of the tips that I can give you so you can acquire khushu' in your salah is understand what you're saying, understand what you're doing. If you say Allahu Akbar, what did it mean? Why don't we say Subhanallah? Why don't we say Alhamdulillah? The minute you say Allahu Akbar and you think about your business, that means your business is Akbar. It's not Allah, you're lying. If you say Allahu Akbar and you think about what you're going to cook tomorrow for iftar, that means food is Akbar, not Allah is Akbar. If you think about anything, the minute you say Allah, that means you're not really meaning it. And why do we stand up like this? Why don't we stand up with our hands behind our backs or behind our heads? Out of humility and respect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Understand what you're doing. Understand, try to understand the verses that are recited in the salah. Someone might say, but I don't understand Arabic. You know what? You should learn some words of Arabic.
How many of us don't know what does the word Jannah mean? All of us know what Jannah is. If you hear the Imam say the word Jannah, Jannat, in your mind, pause and say, Oh Allah, give me Jannah. React to the Quran. If you hear the Imam reciting a verse that says, Subhanallah, Yusabbihu Lillah, stop and say, Subhanallah, glory be to Allah. React to the Quran. That will help you to improve your khushu'. One of the tips that to improve your khushu' in your salah is eat a little bit at iftar. It's so sad the way we eat at iftar nowadays. As if it's going to be the last day of our life to eat. And then when we come for taraweeh, our stomach are so full, we're going to go back and forth. And the people next to us, they know what we had for iftar from the gases that we give out. Eat a little bit. Make a difference this Ramadan. Eat a little bit at iftar. And after taraweeh, you can eat and finish it up. These are some of the tips that will give you the ability to acquire khushu'. So we need to plan for the month of Ramadan just like we plan for everything else. Study the rules of siyam. It's so sad that a lot of people do not know what are the rules of siyam. I get parents asking me if their children should fast. I said, how old are your children? Oh, she's only 17. Like, 17? That's old. We need to understand what happens if you eat by mistake. What happens if you drink by mistake? What happens if you didn't take a shower before Fajr? Study these things until when you're going to be ignorant about your religion. Open the book of Fiqh al-Sirah or Fiqh al-Sunnah and try to read about what Siyam is and what's the ruling of fasting. Any book of Fiqh and try to learn a little bit. And it will help you to increase your benefit from the month of Ramadan. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it among the blessed months and Omar us among those who are forgiven. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُ بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أفضل المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وعلى تابعيهم ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. We are talking about how to get the most out of Ramadan, and it's really hard to get that in 20 minutes or 30 minutes. But go on your own and read articles, listen to lectures, read books about how to get the best out of Ramadan, and don't let this month just pass by like any other month. Remember that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was getting up on his minbar and the companions heard him saying, Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. They asked him later, what happened, O Prophet of Allah? He said, Jibreel came to me and he made three du'as. And in each one of the du'as I said, Ameen. You know one of the du'as, what did Jibreel say? رَغِمَ أَنْفُ عَبْدٍ أَدْرَكَ رَمَضَانٍ وَلَمْ يُغْفَرْ لَهُ. He is a loser. The one who lived through Ramadan, yet he's not forgiven. Prophet Muhammad, what did he say? Ameen. Why? Because with all these blessings, with all these chances, yet you do not take advantage of it, that's a big loss. That's a disgraceful loss. So let us try to understand. I would like to share with you some of the things that we don't want to do this Ramadan. The don'ts of Ramadan. A lot of habits that people got used to it and we don't want to do it anymore. Just at least this Ramadan. Do not waste time. Do not waste time, especially watching TV. Nowadays, all the satellite stations, they compete in putting you something called Ramadani shows. And they have nothing to do with Ramadan. You'll have plenty of time later on to watch TV, record it, DVR it, whatever you can. And later on after the month, we don't have time to waste. We need to go to pray. We need to read Quran. Don't waste time watching TV. Do not waste time going to the malls and shopping. If you go to the mall once a day, you need half an hour to get there, half an hour to find a parking spot, 2 hours in the mall, and 1 hour to go back home. That's 4 hours. You can finish four juzos of the Quran in these 4 hours. Wait. You'll have plenty of time later. Let us not waste time arguing and fighting. Remember, shaitan is locked. And because shaitan knew he's going to be locked in the month of Ramadan, he's going to create a fight for you before Ramadan so you can be busy with it until the end of Ramadan. You're not going to fall into that trick. So if you have a problem between you and your wife, go today to your wife or to your husband's sisters and tell him, we're not going to fight this month. After Ramadan, we'll fight again. But let's stop right now for 30 days. Ramadan is locked, shaitan is locked, he's not going to interfere in our lives. Let us not waste time in fighting and arguing. Let us not fall into the temptation of fighting with others. You're driving on the freeway, the person behind you did not like the way you drive. Normally, they'll pull next to you, either they'll give you a hug or they'll give you a bad sign. You're going to say, Allahumma inni sa'im. Between you and yourself. وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. Do not get into fights and arguments. At work, at school. If someone says something bad to you, say, Allahumma inni sa'im. Let us, again, not eat a lot. We said, let us take some time off from our sleeping. Let us sleep 1 hour less this year and wake up before Fajr or before Suhoor and pray and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And let us stay away from the bad companionships. Those friends of yours who just want to have iftar and go to the shisha bar so they can drink shisha, they can smoke shisha, tell them, no, I'm going to do iftar and go to the masjid. Listen to the juzu of this beautiful recitation. And then pray 8 rak'ahs with my community. And listen to the witr and cry in the dua. Cry. Let us cry this Ramadan. Let us get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, this khutbah's purpose is just to motivate you a little bit to get into the month of Ramadan. If you decided to start praying in Ramadan, if you decided just to come to the masjid this Ramadan, do not be discouraged by those who come and tell you, oh, you are a Ramadani person. No. If you decided to get a little bit better during the month of Ramadan, do not listen to those who tell you, oh, you do that only in Ramadan. Actually tell them, I am one among those who heard the secret call of the angels. As Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, at the beginning of Ramadan, two angels will come down to earth. One of them will say, Ya baghi al khayri, aqbil. Oh, you who seek goodness, get closer. Wa ya baghi al sharri, aqsir. And you who seek bad or evil, stay away. So if you improve yourself just a little bit during the month of Ramadan, that means you answered that call of the angel. Make a difference this Ramadan. You know, at the beginning of every year, people say around us something called New Year resolution. They decide not to smoke, start working out, and some people have haram resolutions. Let us have something called Ramadan resolution. Let us decide, if you're not praying, I'm going to start praying this Ramadan. And I'm going to commit to it after Ramadan. And every year, you add a little bit to that puzzle, to that brick wall, one brick a year. After 5 or 10 years, you would look at the picture of yourself and say, Alhamdulillah, I've been improved so much because of the blessings of Ramadan. Ramadan, being the U-turn for so many people, make it the U-turn for you. Whatever level you are at, you can even go further and you can improve more. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who understand what Ramadan is. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who take the best advantage of this blessed month. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to clear our hearts from any hatred or bad feelings towards each other. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to free us from hellfire in this month. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the chance to witness Laylatul Qadr this month. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the reward of every person that we fed during the month of Ramadan. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka ya rabbana sami'un qareebun mujibud da'awat. Ibadallah, inna Allah qad amarakum bi amrin bada'a bihi bi nafsihi wa thanna bi malaikati qudsi haythu qala inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'ala an-nabi ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli wa sallim وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وأقم الصلاة.